Hello, I'm Knight of Christ Jesus here. My knowledge and your IQ isn't sufficient. We need the grace of Almighty Father. Therefore, let us begin with a prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, bless and bestow upon us your grace. And let this learning process be helped and guided by your Holy Spirit, so that the knowledge acquired here be used for peace and prosperity of human race. Let this race be the pride of Christ Jesus. Lord, thy kingdom come. Amen. Hello. This session, we shall see the chain rule. It's a very important method or the concept in differentiation. We shall see how this chain rule actually works. Most of the students find this difficult initially to grasp, but over a period of practice, they tend to master the skill. So let's try this today. One simple example I'll take and I'll explain what chain rule actually means and how it works. So consider y equal to x to the power 5 plus 5 whole to the power 3. Be equation 1. And here we will substitute or put x to the power 5 plus 5 equal to u. So it becomes a simpler version of y. So we will get y in terms of u. You will get y equals u cube it becomes. This will be your equation 2. Now if you differentiate this with respect to u, because there is no x here now, so differentiating with respect to u, you get d by du of y. This is now u, not the x, du equal to d by du of u cube. So, we know that d by dx of x to the power n is n into x to the power n minus 1. So, therefore, applying this, we get dy by du equal to 3 into u to the power 3 minus 1, that is 2. So, I'll write it directly this. This will become equation 3. So we have u is equal to x to the power 5 plus 5. Let's take that over here. So you have u is equal to x to the power 5 plus 5. Now u is in terms of x. So differentiate this now with respect to x. You will be getting d by dx of u equals d by dx of x to the power 5 plus 5. So this will become du by dx equal to d by dx of x to the power 5 is 5 into x to the power 5 minus 1, that is nothing but 4, plus d by dx of 5 is 0, because the differentiation of a constant is 0. So therefore d by dx is equal to du by dx is equal to 5x to the power 4. This will be your equation 4. Now if you want dy by dx can be written as per the chain rule, dy by du into du by dx. It is dy by dx is dy by du into du by dx. This forms the chain. So therefore, dy by du from this equation, we have equation 3. dy by du is 3u square. So take that over here, substitute, you get 3u square into du by dx, which is here. Du by dx is equation 4, that is 5x square. So substitute, you get 5x to the power 4. So therefore, substitute u's value. U is equal to x to the power 5 plus 5. Therefore, it will become 3 into x to the power 5 plus 5 whole square into 5x to the power 4. 5 into 3 is 15. Therefore, the 15 comes over here. And then you take your x to the power 4 here. And then you keep the whole of x to the power 5 plus 5 whole square. So, therefore, dy by dx is this. This is the chain rule. The chain rule is dy by dx equals dy by du into du by dx. Thank you. This session we shall see chain rule in three steps, that is dy by dx can be expressed as dy by dv into dv by du into du by dx, that is the three step method. So we'll see that with a proper suitable example. Let y equal to log of sine of root x to the base e. So this be equation 1. Now here I can put let u equal to root x. This becomes equation 2. Then the equation will become y equal to log of sine u to the base e. Now this is equation 3. Now again we'll substitute, put sine u equal to v. Then the equation 3 gets resolved to y equal to log v to base e. This will be our equation 4. Now since y is related to v, we'll differentiate with respect to v. Diff with respect to v. Then you'll be getting d by dv. D by dv of y equal to d by dv of log v to base e. So therefore this will become dy by dv equal to 1 by v, because d by dx of log x is 1 by x. So therefore d by dv of log v will be equal to 1 by v. This is our equation 5. Now how is v related? V is related to u. V is sin u. So let's take that equation, v equal to sin u. So now let's differentiate this one, that is diff with respect to u, because v is related to sin u. So it is expressed in terms of u. So you will be getting d by du of v equal to d by du of sin u. So therefore this will become dv by du equal to cos u. So this is equation 6. Now there is another one, u equal to x. U is related to x. So take that equation, we will be getting u equal to root x. So differentiate this with respect to x. Then you will get d by dx of u equal to d by dx of root x. Root x is nothing but, root is written as x to the power of. So this can also be written as d by dx of x to the power half. So it's like d by dx of x to the power n. X to the power n is equal to n into x to the power n minus 1. Therefore this will become half into x to the power half minus 1. That is nothing but half into x to the power minus half, which can be written as x whole divided by 2 to the power 2 into x to the power half, which is nothing but 1 by 2 into root x. So therefore you will be getting du by dx equal to 1 by 2 root x. So then we have this v in terms of u, u in terms of x, v in terms of u, and we have v in terms of y in terms of u. So therefore if you want dy by dx, this should be dy by dv into dv by du into du by dx. Therefore this is dy by dv is this. That is nothing but 1 by v. So I put this as 1 by v into dv by du. Dv by du is cos u. That is cos u into du by dx. That is 1 by 2 root x. Substitute for u and v. V is nothing but, v is nothing but sin u. So this can be written as 1 by sin u into cos u into 1 by 2 root x. But cos u by sin u is nothing but cot u. Because sin theta by cos theta is cot theta. So it will become cot u into 1 by 2 root x. But u is nothing but root x. So substituting there we get this one as cot of root x whole divided by 2 root x. Therefore dy by dx is equal to that. This is a conventional way of breaking the complex differential equation into subfunctions and differentiating each subfunction and then taking the multiplication of that and finding arriving at dy by dx. Expressing dy by dx as dy by dv, dv by du into du by dx. Finally we come to x. So literally you can say this will get cancelled, this will get cancelled, this will get, therefore dy by dx. But generally we don't do that, but you can think it that way. But this is the chain rule, this is how it goes about. Okay, thank you. previous session, we saw chain rule, two-step and three-step method. I'll take three-step method and I'll show you without taking U and B and stuff like that and complicating how to do directly. Okay? Assume the chain rule to be in boxes. Say for example, you have a goal, you have a big box, you unwrap that big box, you'll find a small box in it, you'll unwrap that small box, you will find at another small box in it, you unwrap that small box and open and see, you'll have a diamond ring which you're supposed to use it for proposal of your girlfriend. Okay, so something like that you can take chain rule as. I'll show you. See, the previous equation we took, y equal to log of sine root x to the base e. So consider this is one wrapper, one box, and this is another box. This overall thing is another box. So this is something like y is equal to log x. The whole of it, you assume it's like x. Differentiation of log x is 1 by x. So therefore, differentiating with respect to x itself, x, we get dy by dx equal to log, the whole thing, you assume it is x. So therefore, log x will be 1 by x. So 1 divided by x. X is nothing but the whole of it. That is sine of root x. Since this is not like root x, you see, into d by dx of whatever this thing is there, that is in the second box wrapper or brackets or parenthesis. So it will become sine of root x. So you open the outer thing, box. Now you have inside another box, you are going to open that with this. That box contains sine of root of x. So therefore, this will result in dy by dx equal to 1 by sine of root x into differentiation of sine. Differentiation of sine is cos. So cos x. D by dx of sine x is cos x. So consider this is not like cos x. This is not like x. But consider this is like sine x. Then it will become cos x. So write cos. Since it's not x, it is root x. So keep it as it is. Since this is not like x, you have to go do again chain rule d by dx of root x. So that is the third wrapper box you are opening. The outer one is over, then the second one you open. Now you got to open this one. When you open this one, you got this. Since there is one more box, opening that d by dx, the inner one, and then the inner one, outer one, and the second one is also open. To open the third one, you have into d by dx of the in middle box. So that is d by dx of x. But everybody knows that d by dx of x is 1 by 2 root x. So previously also we saw. So this can be written as cos of root x divided by sine of root x into d by dx of root x is nothing but 1 by 2 root x by x to the power n method itself. So cos by sine is nothing but cot. So this can be written as cot of root x into 1 by 2 root x can be written as whole divided by 2 root x. This gets done in less number of steps and it is easy to achieve without taking u, v and other variables. Thank you.
my heartfelt gratitude for this video, viewers. May God bless you all.